Yeah, well, I'm going to throw in there Jared Allen, too. The at-bats that Jared and Will gave us were indicative of an experienced players, even though they're freshmen. They fought, they clawed, they gave us quality at-bats, and that's all we're asking of our guys. We never ask them to get hits, we just ask them to give us quality at-bats. And, yeah, the frustration is mounting. It definitely is within the coaching staff. I'm sure it is in the players' faces. When I went out to take out Saberhagen, the look on the face when the score was 3-0 was like it was 13-0. That bothered me a lot because in a midweek game, if we don't have the mentality to recover from 3-0, then we don't deserve the right to wear the uniforms. And I'll take full responsibility. We have got to find another gear to compete at. We knew it wasn't going to be easy. It's never going to be easy. And I think we're backing down to the toughness now. When it gets tough, we're backing down. That really has bothered me and my coaching staff tremendously.
You talk about them finding that other gear. Are there other things that you guys are thinking you could fix or other answers you think are out there up to the offense right now?
Well, we don't have a lot of depth. So, that's part of the problem. I'm so used to having depth at many positions where guys have to show up to play each and every day, or they know there's someone behind them just as good that could take their spot. There can be some complacency. I think there's some selfishness going on. I'm not so sure, and this is what I'm going to have to dig into. I'm not so sure it's about our long faces isn't because of the score and how we're playing. It's about the negativity that's going on within themselves personally, with their at-bats, their defense. And we've got to get that fixed. We've got to be a team that is committed to one thing, and that's playing together for the success of the team.
Are you surprised that that's creeping up maybe at this point of the season, Dave, when you're basically through your non-conference portion?
I don't know if that's it for sure. I'm just throwing that out there. I've seen since we've hit this skid, it's become about the results of their at-bats, and I don't like that feeling because this is a team sport, and we need to grind. We got out-grinded tonight, and that really bothers me. We got out-grinded by Tennessee Tech, and nothing against Tennessee Tech. Their mentality was better than us. I tip my hat to them. Their at-bats were better. They were tougher outs. They took better swings. They threw better pitches. Tip their hat. They deserve to win the game tonight.
How do you go about trying to change that mentality or fixing things in the next 2 days before you open league play on Friday?
Well, there's a lot of different things that are going through my head right now. I'll sleep on that tonight and come to a decision with my coaching staff. What's the best direction to go with this team? But we have to make this turn around and head in a different direction. We got a long road ahead of us. The SEC is upon us now. We know that's the toughest part of our schedule in those 30 games, and we have a lot of work to do in a long. And I think people understand now why when we were winning so much, when we were winning early, and I kept saying we have a lot of work to do, it's come to fruition now. I saw that from the long distance, even though we were winning, and we do have a lot of work to do, and our guys have to strap it on and get on board, because I think we're proven that we aren't talented enough to not show up every day to be the best we can be that day and scrap and claw. We don't have that ability right now. And we know that within our clubhouse. They've all said this, we may not be as talented as we've been in the past, so we have to be the best team. So we know that, but we're not performing that way.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you.